Today, I'll be going over the best Kovacs routine to become a good aimer in Fortnite. Kovacs is literally a free pass to get good aim, and I think everyone should play it if they want to take their gameplay to the next level. It's insane how much consistency, smoothness, and accuracy you can build up after playing the game for an hour a day consistently. Before we get into today's video, for every 1,000 users we get on code MARINTM in the item shop, I'll be coaching one of you guys for a full tournament session. And let's aim for 5,000 likes on today's video, and with that all said, let's get into today's episode. So in today's video, I'll have three routines for beginners, intermediate aimers, and pro aimers. You can go for whatever routine you feel suits you, but for the most effective improvement, I would not recommend going for something that is too hard. The first of five maps you want to play in the beginner routine is Smoothness Trainer. This is a map that takes 30 seconds to complete, and it's the perfect map to learn the principles of reactive aiming instead of predictive aiming. What reactive aiming means is that you never, at any time, try to predict the bot's movement. If it moves one way, you think mentally that it will keep moving that way forever. But the second the bot moves, or in other words, changes direction, you flick on to it. The reason you never want to have a predictive aim is because it's inconsistent. You can't consistently predict an enemy's movement in Fortnite, nor can you predict a bot's movement in Kovacs. Lastly, I want to mention that on this map, you're rewarded for being on center target. You get a higher score by aiming on the middle of the bot compared to the sides. So keep that in mind when playing this map. So on this map, you want to use your ADS sensitivity on 103 Overwatch FOV. In order to find your ADS sensitivity, you want to multiply your hipfire sensitivity with your ADS percent. So I use 13.5 hipfire sensitivity on Fortnite, I then multiply that with 50% and find my ADS sensitivity. In order to get this in on Kovacs, you simply go to the main settings tab, use Fortnite percent as sensitivity scale, and type in 6.75. And for FOV, you go to FOV measurements, click in Overwatch, and type 103. The second map in this routine is Thin Aiming Long Invincible Easy. This map is more or less just a slightly harder version than Smoothness Trainer because of all the direction changes the bomb makes. The same rules apply on this map as on Smoothness Trainer. You want to play it on 103 Overwatch FOV and with your ADS sensitivity. The third map in this routine is going to be Fountain Tracking Easy. And this is arguably one of the most influential maps in this entire routine, because you practice vertical tracking, something no one ever practices, and this is going to give you a huge competitive edge. On this map, you definitely should not play on 103 Overwatch FOV, but rather on 80. From personal experience, 80 is much more realistic and it gives way more effective practice. Moving on to the second to last map in the beginner routine, we have Pokeball Frenzy Auto TE. And this is an interesting map, so pay close attention. This is a flicking practice map, but you want to hold down your shoot button for the entire run. Once you land on a target, stay there for a few milliseconds until it pops. This is a track to flick map, and it will drastically help your flicks and make your aim way more consistent. On this map, you should play your hipfire sensitivity with 103 Overwatch FOV. The final map for the beginner routine is Reflex Flick Easy. And on this map, you want to hit the target, then reset your crosshair to the center of the screen. My flicking is arguably my weakest link when it comes to aiming. That's why I flick so incredibly slowly in the background footage. I am because I just started flick training, focusing on accuracy over speed first so I can correctly learn the precise movements to hit a target without over flicking. Whether going for accuracy or speed is better when it comes to improving has been a little bit of a debate in the aiming community, and honestly, I think it all comes down to personal preference. If you're a speed demon and want to get a lot of clicks but low accuracy, then you should go for that. If you're a slow, steady, and precise player like me, then go for accuracy. I believe both works. On this map, it's crucial that you use 103 Overwatch FOV and your hipfire sensitivity. Now, we're moving on to the intermediate aimer routine. And the first map in this routine is Ascended Tracking V3. This map is insane for smoothness when it comes to your aim. The reason behind this is because the more center you aim on the target, the higher score you'll get. This map has both a target switching and some of the best tracking practice you'll find in a Kovacs map. I'm honestly surprised this map isn't brought up more in Kovacs routines, because if you were only to play this map for an hour a day and nothing else for the next month, your aim would still improve like crazy. On this map, you should play with your ADS sensitivity and 103 Overwatch FOV. To absolutely no one's surprise, the next map is Thin Aiming Lung Invincible. This is by far my favorite map on Kovacs, and I think it's the single map that has helped me the most with tracking this last month. On this map, you should focus completely on your smoothness when the bot is moving either to the left or right. Don't think about the fact that the bot is going to change direction anytime soon. When it happens, it happens. And on this map, you should play 80 FOV with your ADS sensitivity. The third map is none other than Bounce 180. This map is incredibly challenging, yet has an amazing impact on your shotgun aim. When you first play this map, you will most likely have a pretty hard time being consistent. So to improve this, I would recommend focusing on accuracy first. Focusing on accuracy instead of speed and target hit on this map will make sure you improve way more exponentially and that you don't create any bad habits. In contrast to Reflex Flick Easy, I don't think speed is a good alternative to go for on this map, simply because the way the targets are moving and because this map is way more difficult. On this map, you should play 103 Overwatch FOV and your hipfire sensitivity. Fourth in the intermediate routine, we have the map 1W60TE Varied TPS. This map is great to help make your micro adjustments better, your flicks more accurate, and your overall speed just higher. There is not too much to be said about this map, other than you should try to be as effective as possible with the targets you hit. Don't go for one target all the way on the bottom and flick all the way to the top on the next one. Go for the targets that are closest to each other and focus on your target efficiency. Just like on Bounce 180, you want to use 103 Overwatch FOV and your hipfire sensitivity. Lastly, we have the map Air Invincible. This map is great for both close range AR and SMG aim. What I want you guys to work with on this map is holding a chill grip on your mouse and simply just trying to be as smooth as possible. And when the target switches direction, you want to flick back on it. This is one of those maps that literally help improve everything and is one of the fundamental Kovacs maps you have to play if you're investing time into the game. On this map, you should use your hipfire sensitivity and 103 Overwatch FOV. Moving on, we have the pro routine. And I just want to say, before we start, this routine is more or less too hard for me personally, and I'm not a bad aimer at all. However, this routine will drastically help anyone with their aim that is at a relatively high level. And the map playing in the background is Smoothsphere. You want to play this map on 80 FOV with your ADS sensitivity and try your best to be as smooth as possible with good corrections. In my opinion, this map is unbelievable. It's an amazing yet super frustrating map. If you feel like you have good aim, play this map and let me know your score in the comments below. The second map in the pro routine is Fortnite Gliders. And I know what you guys are thinking, but Marin, there isn't even launch pads in the game. Why would I play a aim map based on people gliding? Well, guys, let me tell you that this map is not only good for people gliding. This map will drastically improve your ADS aim on anyone running, swimming, or simply just rotating. You want to play this one on 80 FOV with your ADS sensitivity. The last map in this pro routine is 1 wall, 5 targets, underscore Pazu reload. This map helps with consistency in your shotgun aim a ton. And trust me, if you play this map a lot, you will start doing more and more damage to your opponents. Perfect for a spaz season. Anyways guys, that is going to be the Kovacs video. I really hope you enjoyed it, and hopefully you'll see this video as a sign to start taking aim training seriously. My name is MarinTM, stay safe and take care.